Hi, imagine we have an aircraft here which is flying from a point A to a point B with a given trajectory, for example, something like that. And we want to know the traveled distances, x and y here. Each value can be positive or negative. All we know is the airspeed, which depends on time here, v of t, and the heading, theta, which depends also on time. Okay, so first, let's see mathematically what is the result. First, the speed can be separated into two components. The component on that axis here, let's call this value vx, and the second one, which is here, which is vy. Okay, so we can calculate easily Vx and Vy, function of V and theta. We have Vx equals V multiplied by the sine of theta of time, and Vy equals V multiplied by the cosine of theta of time. And what is the speed? The speed is the derivative of the position by time. Okay, so we can calculate x and y, a function of v and theta. We have x equals the integral of 0 to time t, okay, of dx. So this is the integral 0 to time. V, so V depends on time also, of course, multiplied by the sine of theta of time dt, and y equals the integral of 0 to t of V dt multiplied by the cosine of theta of time dt. Okay, so this is not complicated. But imagine that we are in the 50s or 60s. Back in the days, this kind of computation is not easy. So a special mechanical part was used for that purpose. This part is called a Ball resolver. I will explain you in one moment what is a Ball resolver. Okay, so inside the Ball resolver, there is a ball, as its name implies. The diameter of the ball is generally 1 or 2 inches. The ball resolver is shown from the top here. Below the ball, there is a drive roller. The drive roller is in contact with the ball, of course. Okay, and the drive roller rotates at a speed which depends on the airspeed of the aircraft. Okay, so the speed here, omega, is proportional to the airspeed of the aircraft with a constant, let's say, k. Okay. And also the roller can rotate here, so the position of the roller depends on the heading of the aircraft. There is an angle here, which is exactly the heading of the aircraft, theta, which depends on time. For example, the aircraft is like that here. Okay, if the aircraft flies from west to east, for example, the roller will be on that direction here. Okay, so the ball will rotate depending on the position of the drive roller here. For example, in that position, the ball will rotate also like that. Okay. So now we have also two other rollers which are fixed in position here. One here and another one here. And these two rollers are the output of that system actually. You can see that the speed of this roller, let's call this speed xy, on les appelle. So this is omega, omega, omega y, it will be easier like that. And this one, omega x. Okay, so you can see immediately that the speed of this roller, for example, will depend, of course, on the drive speed of the roller, but also on the heading. For example, if the heading is zero, in that case, the ball will rotate like that, and the speed of this roller will be maximum. But if you suppose that the roller, the drive roller, is on that direction, in that case, the ball will rotate on that axis here, and the speed of this one will be zero, but the other one will be maximum. We can say that the speed of this roller, omega y, equals the drive speed here, omega. We can call that thing omega drive, omega d. Okay, so we have omega drive multiplied by a constant which depends on the diameter of the drive roller, the diameter of the output roller here, so multiplied by another constant, A for example, and multiplied by the cosine of theta of time. And for the other roller, omega x equals omega drive multiplied by the same constant. If you suppose that the diameter of the rollers are identical, multiplied by the sine of theta of time. And what is omega? Omega actually is the speed of the roller, so it is the derivative of the angle. So this is the angle theta y. So omega y is the derivative of the angle versus time, and this is the same for omega x. This is d theta, this one is theta y, theta x divided by time here. Okay, so what is the angle theta y? Theta y is the integral of 0 to time of d theta y, and we can calculate, it is not complicated. So this is a constant A multiplied by the integral of 0 of time, omega d depends of time, omega drive of time multiplied by the cosine of theta of time dt. Okay, and we have the same formula for the second angle, theta x, omega drive of time multiplied by the sine of theta of time dt. Okay, and we found the equations of x and y of the original problem. So we can see that this ball resolver is actually a polar to Cartesian converter, a mechanically converter. So we can see that if we are able to drive this drive roller with a speed which is proportional to the airspeed of the aircraft, therefore the angles of the two output rollers correspond actually to the position of the aircraft, the longitude and the latitude of the aircraft. So this thing was used in navigation computers in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. It is used, for example, in the navigation computer of the Boeing 707. You can see on the screen an example. So this is an extract of a patent which uses a ball resolver. We can see the ball here. The speed input is a shaft in orange here. There is a bevel gear which permits to transmit the speed to the drive roller, 25, in blue here. The complete assembly can rotate. This is a hollow shaft in pink color here. This hollow shaft is driven using the servo control, and the angle of this shaft is the heading of the aircraft. We can see two ball bearings here, which permits to this hollow shaft to rotate from the body of this ball resolver. And we can see also two other small ball bearings here, which permit the rotation of the input shaft relative to the hollow shaft. So on the bottom, there is one output roller, this one here. The second one is on that direction, like that. I just received this packet from UK. If you want to send me something in UK, you can use this address. This is an original box. As you can see, this thing is a ball resolver, 2 inches. There is a date here, 1964. Okay, so this is a beautiful example of a ball resolver. This one is new. Okay, we can see the input shaft here. This is the heading input. And we can see the two outputs orthogonally placed. This one and this one. You can see the two rollers here. And we can see also two idler rollers. This one and this one. This permits to the ball to have a fixed position. The center of the ball doesn't change. And there should be also another roller on that thing. Okay, we can see the bevel gear, the drive roller is here, this flange is the second input which corresponds to the heading. Okay, it permits the rotation of the complete assembly here. We can see the ball inside. Okay, so let's remove the other side. Okay, so this one is called the Castor roller. And there are several hard points. Okay, it's better now. Okay, so the orientation of this roller actually will be the same than the orientation of this one. Okay, and this is the ball. This is a beautiful ball, almost perfect, I think. Normally, the diameter should be 2 inches, exactly 5.08 centimeters. Okay, so we can see that on that position here, only this roller rotates. Okay, so if I rotate the heading by 90 degrees, like that, so now this roller rotates, and this one doesn't. Or a little bit. Okay. And if I rotate by 45 degrees, like that, the two rollers rotate. Next time you will see the navigation computer of the Boeing 707. It is called the CPA-24B1. This is this device. Inside, there is a ball resolver. We will do a teardown, and also I will do the reverse engineering of that thing, and I will try to get it work. Thank you for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye.